Hello, my love bugs. Today, we're going to talk about something a little more lighthearted. We're going to talk about yoga. All right. So, I've noticed that... How do I say this? Everybody has their own way of teaching, and everybody has their own style. Me, personally, coming from a athletic background, I love mirrors. Mirrors in the studio, chef's kiss. They allow people to see what they're doing. If they want to check, if they don't, then they don't have to look. But a lot of times, what you feel is not actually in alignment because we've been conditioned to compensate for other things. So I like when there's a mirror available for someone to check. Something else I do in my classes is I do demo a lot of the practice. And here's why. Nobody wants to be stared at while they're doing anything. That's my number one. Number two, even if you're listening and moving with the words that are coming out of my mouth, occasionally you might have a disconnect and you're like, oh snap. And you like to look up and see, you know, where the teacher is. Is this correct? Like, did I hear you wrong? That's why I demo. To me, just walking around a class, pointing out people's flaws is not as uplifting as it could be. So I try to make my classes very woosah. Like, I don't want you to feel judged ever. Because that's my number one thing. I want you to come in. I want you to take this time for you. It is your practice. You know what works. You know what doesn't. You know your body. You know your mind. I'm not about to sit here and tell you how to fix all of that. You might not even need fixing, quote unquote. But either way, yoga is it's a practice of exploration. You need to explore thoughts, feelings, emotions, sensations, all of that. And I'm trying to create an area or a space where people can do that without having to have all these little voices in their head like, oh, she's looking at me, or, oh, am I doing this right? Now, don't get me wrong. I do make adjustments because sometimes the way people are practicing, it's just unsafe and I don't want anybody to get hurt. So that is why I do the hands-on adjustments. Now, not all teachers teach this way. Some people barely demo and they prefer to walk around the whole time and, you know, make adjustments here and there. And that's perfectly fine. That's their style of class. I cue anatomically and with postures. I may or may not use Sanskrit. There's so many different aspects to the practice and different ways you can interpret it and, you know, provide a all-inclusive class for your students. I'm not saying anybody's is right or wrong. I'm just saying everybody has their own styles. So, you know, one style might work for you that doesn't work for someone else. I personally am not a fan of a snake oil salesman type of teacher. One that talks holier than now, I am the knowledge of all. I don't personally care for that kind because it's belittling, and I don't want anybody to feel belittled. But I just wanted to say that this is just my perspective on teaching in my class, to each their own. I'm not here to judge. I 100% am not. But my main concern is my clients and their overall well-being and how they feel in my class, not just physically, but mentally and emotionally. So with that being said, find a teacher that you like, find a style that you like, and just enjoy the practice. It doesn't have to be perfect. It's not about that. It has so many other benefits that focusing on the perfection of a pose is just not necessary. Namaste.